Hello Taurus, thank you for watching this weekly tarot reading and let's see what cards are showing up for you. Thank you so much for watching. I also have other videos, of course. This is for your Moon, Sun, Rising and Venus sign in the zodiac sign Taurus. And I also have the other zodiac signs if you want to check it out. For Taurus, what I can see here is the Nine of Wands in reverse shows up in reverse, so maybe you feel a little bit paranoid about something. You feel a little bit overly cautious about something. And the Death card in reverse showed up in the past. So there was in the past there was some kind of change coming up, but it's not completely there yet. So maybe you've been waiting for someone to change their mind, or someone to be on the same page as you are. And there was very much in their benefit. They're very happy about over something that happened between you. So if this was like something physical, I think it was maybe like only for the pleasure or something, maybe. But I think with you there's more feelings involved. I think on their side as well. I do see only watery cards here in the past. So I think this is about sharing that love with each other. But it could also be a lot about pleasure and having fun. But this is probably changing, or it changed in a way that maybe from friendship to something more than a friendship, for example. And I think there are more feelings here involved with the two of you. So maybe you're a little bit paranoid, a little bit cautious about this connection, like what's going to be next. And I get as clarification cards the Sun and the Strength Tarot card. So maybe you're a bit cautious about this, but you know you don't have to be have to show this. You know you don't know yet what's going to happen, so you're not going to think about it yet. And this other person is seeing this as a something very positive, very bright. They're very positive about this connection, like. So I think this worry that you're having at the moment, and that feeling of maybe that you did something wrong, or that you was just too harsh on them, or maybe you was just a little bit rude, or maybe you made some jokes that were not appropriate, or something that you have been doing was maybe something that you regret later on, or something that you feel worried about. But I think they see this only as something positive. Is that possible? They see this as some kind of bright new start. So I think that this was coming from both sides. I think you're more on the same page than you think. You're more on the same page as you think. So if you thought you have been doing something wrong, maybe this person is like that as well. So they really understand, because they just do it in return when they really don't like it. So they are, it's not someone probably that is completely different from who you are. You probably look like each other in a way. So the Two of Pentacles in reverse on a conscious level, together with the Ace of Cups and the Hierophant, could be that you're dropping some tasks. Maybe you had more options, more people that you are interested in, or they were interested in you. And with the Hierophant, you find this a little bit maybe unconventional, a little bit strange. It feels not good anymore to do so, because you are starting to have a great connection with this person that you have on your mind. So this other person feels a little bit drained at the moment. They are maybe seeing this connection as, they really hope there is more in it. I do feel they hope that there is more in it. And I also see from the beginning until the middle of the week, I do see you are caring for each other very well. I see you are both very much making that the other person feels okay as well. And that also makes that this is the end of a certain period, that you are now treating each other in a completely different way. So if this is your steady partner, then you are going to be much more friendly with each other than before. So if there were arguments or whatever, things are going to be solved. And or solved is maybe not the right word, but you are willing again to make that the other person feels at home with you and feels loved and feels cared, as that you like to care for them. There's also that trust coming back. So if you wonder if there wasn't any trust anymore, this is returning. So this trust is coming back. You are trusting this person. They are trusting you. This other person might be not come off as such. So they might be a little bit strict, or they might be a little bit like, oh, don't do that anymore. They will stand up for themselves, but a little bit like with their opinion. They might have an opinion about something, and they are very willing to share this, but they are in general, the Queen of Cups, or sorry, the Queen of Pentacles is more so about that you really like to care for each other. So this is only the way that they are approaching you when they are going to talk about the certain thing that happened. Then it will also only do that a little bit in the background, like, I didn't like this what you did because this and that, but not anymore like an argument or something like that. So the Death tarot card, in the past, I think there were a lot of changes going on. So in your study relationship, or in your new relationship, or if this is something new, someone new or something new, this is the other party, whoever it is, your job, your employee, your new lover, your study partner, they were really happy with a certain thing that you did, with this change that is coming up. You actually, that you are on the conscious level dropping tasks, dropping some options that you had before. So yeah, this worry that you had is now, in this week, you are probably going to focus on this, that you are not going to, you feel maybe a little bit paranoid and everything, but you really try not to show this so off to this other party. You're really not going to show this, and so that also, not maybe not because of this, but I see that the other party is again up for a new positive bright start, and this will come up for them and for you. Yeah, and that's how you're seeing it, is the Two of Swords. So you doubt, like, what should I do with this, how should I deal with this? And I think here with the King of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles, that it looks like maybe you're doubting, but there are maybe no other options. This is just what you want. So maybe you doubt between the kind of work that you are going to do, or you doubt between if I should, because the King of Pentacles is someone who's caring for his family, and the Ten of Pentacles is his family. So maybe you are wondering, or you want to choose, like, should I be with my family or work for my family? So for example, if you have to be at a long distance, work at a long distance to care for your family, maybe you wonder if you should do that or to stay with your family and maybe earn less money, I don't know. But Ten of Pentacles is definitely about wealth. So whatever you're doing, these two choices, these two options that you're having, that money is still there, your family is still there. This is probably the most important for you at the moment, or maybe forever, because you're a Taurus, of course. So yeah, so that family-oriented part and caring for others is something important and something that you actually, so you probably doubting over a certain choice, which are actually the same in the end, or not the same, because if you, of course, you're caring for your family, that's, you're caring for your family, or you're caring for this person, or you want to start a family with this person. It could be that you are, for example, choosing if you want to become an entrepreneur and to work all the time, or to be with your family all the time. But in the end it will be the same, because if you're successful as an entrepreneur, you will be with your family probably more often if you are scheduling this or planning this in such a way, depending on what kind of job you have, of course, or what kind of business you have. So the Ten of Wands is showing up together with the Four of Swords and the High Priestess in reverse. So yeah, there's a lot of responsibilities coming with this, with whatever you are going to do that you feel so worried about and that you feel so a little bit paranoid about. It's coming with a lot of responsibilities, but you will get your rest. There's a lot of rest involved here as well. There's really like a need for a new start. That's what I see with a lot of zodiac signs. There's a new start coming up. And this makes the other party happy as well. So and what is missing here is there are not a lot of swords cards. There are a few. Yeah, there are a few. Otherwise, I would say communication is very important here. And I think as well, I think that there's a lot of communication needed to find out. Because I think you're maybe second guessing what's the best thing to do, but maybe you didn't discuss this yet with the other party, for example. Yeah, the Knight of Cups in reverse, it's like maybe you're being carried away a little bit by your feelings in the end of the week. The Knight of Cups is showing up in reverse together with the Page of Pentacles. And the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. And I think so in the end of the week you may be a little bit carried away. You're being a little bit carried away by your feelings, much more so than your practical side. It's not really a Taurus thing. So so this is something to take note of. That's also what the other party sees. And so maybe they know that you really care, because this is something that you normally do, but in the end of the week you forgot about something, or you you're being maybe head over heels, and so this person is noticing this. I think definitely if you're not watching, I think you already have met someone, but you're just a little bit nervous about the situation and what they think of you maybe, and what you should be doing next and how to deal with this situation, and that things are a little bit strange. Maybe they know already that you, maybe there were some other things going on before that wasn't really that you think that it wasn't in their favor. But maybe it is, because I see in the past that they were really, like the Nine of Cups, they have been wishing for this certain thing. I don't know why, but the Nine of Cups is showing up. So they have been wishing for this certain thing that that you two have experienced together. So yeah, these worries. These worries is something that is going to be slightly different. I think this person wants a family with you. And they are much more so interested in you than you might think. And they are paying very much attention to the details and how the way you act and the way you respond, and not so much to the things that you say or the things that are expected, but they are looking through this. It's not that they are literally interpreting the way you are behaving, but they are looking through this situation. But still, they are not really aligned with their intuition, so it could be that they change their mind over something, but let's see. Okay. Yeah, it could be with the Two of Cups and the Four of Cups in reverse that they maybe think like, oh, this guy or this girl is just not interested. They are not so much interested. And so this makes it a little bit hard for them as well. Do you both know that you like each other? That's really a little bit like the feeling I got. Do you know that? Maybe you haven't even told each other yet, or you are just trying both to read between the lines all the time. If this was because of, maybe you have been with a person that's normally your friend and something more happened between you, for example, but you are not directly communicating with each other about this. It's not, maybe they have a secret or there's some kind of secret going on, or this is a secret, but it's more that you're reading between the lines than rather than really talking directly towards each other. That's the feeling I've got. And I think this person is definitely interested. They are interested in you. They want more from you. But I think in the end of the week, you really need to be a little bit more grounded about this. And if possible, to stop worrying about this. But I do see that this is a difficult situation for you. But you do feel rest for some reason. So maybe you have been accepting these feelings that you have for this person, and that already comes with a lot of rest in your mind. Yeah, so whatever is going on, Taurus, I wish you a very beautiful week. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and check also the other signs for your moon sign, Venus sign, and rising sign. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.